Good morning, everyone. How are you all doing? Awesome. Welcome to our session, Create Teams of Technology Leaders. Okay. Hi, I'm Shravanti Inga Reddy, Director of Salesforce Development at Teach for America. And here is my great colleague, Ramya Ramamurthy, Managing Director of Salesforce Development. And we both work for Teach for America. To give you a bit of background of what our organization does, Teach for America recruits and places graduates from top universities into struggling schools in impoverished neighborhoods. This is to reduce the educational inequity in rural and urban communities. Our aim is to realize one day every child gets an equal opportunity to learn, grow, influence, and lead. Here is a familiar safe forward statement that you must have looked at a million times by now. But Salesforce is a publicly traded company, so you should make your purchasing decisions based on the products and services that are currently available. Agenda for today. First, we're going to define what technology leadership is. And second, we're going to discuss how to create technology leaders and the tools to deal with obstacles along the process. Finally, you'll walk away with resources and knowledge to empower your team and build technology leaders in your organization. So, what does leadership mean? Many books and various authorities have defined it millions of different ways. For the purposes of this talk, leadership is about having a clear vision, inspiring or influencing others with your actions and words. There are many other definitions of leadership revolve around the topics of resource allocation or functional skill training, and these subjects fall under the category of management and therefore will not discuss here today. So now you might be wondering, how is technology leadership any different? Right. We believe that the technology leaders have an additional responsibility of ensuring that the technology deployed aligns with the organizational goals and strategies. In today's world, the stakes for technology leaders couldn't be higher. According to the World Economic Forum, if technology was taken as its own country, it would be the third largest country by GDP. Given its magnitude of $6 trillion, we need quality stewardship of this enormous amount of resources. Pursuant to that, let's discuss how to cultivate effective technology leaders in our organizations. So on your journey to cultivating technology leaders in your organization, we have identified four main areas. First, we're going to discuss how to cultivate specific leadership skills. Second, how to provide these opportunities to practice these skills. Third, we'll focus on how to keep your technology skill current. Fourth, we'll discuss how to build your relationships within the organization. Finally, we'll note some common pitfalls that we have encountered during our many interviews with our technology leaders. To start, we have identified some of the most important skills for leader to have in their repertoire. Communication is what you need to effectively communicate and share your ideas so that other people on the team can understand and follow your vision. For instance, if you have a great idea and you want to clearly communicate the problem statement, solution options, and the benefits to the team. Coaching and delegation involves mentoring and providing support to your team members on their journey for their successful execution of the project. I personally know it's all too well, and it's tempting to get into what I like to call it as a small business owner mentality. often it's easier one to feel that it's easy, it's more efficient to do projects themselves than coach your junior resources and check the resultant work. However, this approach is not scalable. So it becomes very important for them to learn to delegate sooner than later. As a leader, it's very important to reflect and be able to receive and provide authentic feedback to check if the path one is taking is leading to the right results. Finally, strategic thinking is very crucial in ensuring that the projects that people working on are aligned with the organizational goals. However, to practice these skills, we need to provide opportunities. In our company, we work in an agile environment. So everyone on the team, irrespective of their title, will get an opportunity to lead projects and take initiative. This has proven very successful for us. And the key here is to provide the necessary support and direction. Providing stretch opportunities aids in decision-making capabilities. These opportunities are conducive to providing leadership skills. They will learn to communicate ideas to various stakeholders, build consensus around solutions, and they will be able to receive coaching with the team leaders that they collaborate with, right? The third most important skill as a technology leader is to keeping up with the current technology. We learn a lot of, we work with a lot of technologies, people around us, so we learn a lot from our experts and also learn from online resources such as websites, blogs, and forums, and so on. Given how fast the technology changes, it becomes very important for you to select the best possible technology that's available in the market to meet your organization needs. By staying current, you will avoid building costly in-house solutions and instead benefit from the state-of-the-art technologies and ideas available in the market. And we cannot deny the fact that how crucial the networking is on your journey to becoming leader. For instance, I have attending Salesforce user groups or events such as World Tour or conferences like Dreamforce are one way to keeping up with the latest technology. So last time when I attended the Salesforce World Tour at New York City, I had the opportunity to consult with experts to gain knowledge and also learn what's new in the Salesforce Lightning and how Salesforce uses emerging technologies such as blockchain or AI in solving the business problems. This has helped me and my team to smoothly transition to Lightning. So these are our few of our personal recommendations. If you're excited, you can clap once. If some of it is your favorite here that shows up. Anyone? Any claps here? Salesforce blogs? Okay. My personal favorites are Shell Block, Douglas Ayers, and many more, which I couldn't list all of them, but they are great. Online magazines. So this is a great way if you subscribe or read Hacker News or Slashdot to keep up with what's going in the market. Not necessarily Salesforce, right? You need to know what's going on to help your organization solve the problems. And massive open online courses. My personal favorite for Salesforce is Lynda and Udemy. They have great courses and you should definitely watch out. And Lightning Now community. How many of you are here as part of that community? Okay, great, I see one hand though. So I highly recommend that you should join, and this has greatly helped our team to transition to Lightning smoothly. Trailhead, I'm sure every one of you are here. And finally, the Salesforce Developer YouTube channel. Highly, highly, highly recommend if you want to know deep dive into any technological resources. So everything is available there. Podcasts, anyone? Okay, so Salesforce does offer podcasts, and my personal favorite is Admin Podcast, if you want to know what's going on. So there are other podcasts, so of course. So our final thing on your, the final skill that you need to acquire on your leadership journey is building and strengthening relationships within your organization. One way to achieve strengthening relationships is through team cohesion. So what is team cohesion? Team cohesion is the ability to work on a shared goal, work together for a shared goal, right? As you can see here, higher the cohesive teams you have, the more productivity you have. Now, how do we achieve this team cohesiveness? First, leaders cannot lead unless they understand the people they are leading. So it's very important for team to understand each other and their each other's skills and their personality. And this is very, and each member should be accounted for and has their own input. Second, teams should be invested in the success of other team members. So to that end, we want to promote social events. We want to promote team fellowship through social events. To achieve both ends are team building activities. Team building activities also reinforces the team perception as the organization believes, as the team believes that the organization is invested in the success of the team as a whole. Workshops and games are a great way to engage one another in learning each other's skills at a more personal level. Since our company operates in an agile environment, we use retrospective meetings as a way to appreciate and admire one's skills. So that concludes our four areas that we have identified. Now Ramya will share the most common pitfalls that we have encountered while we interviewed many technology leaders across various organizations. Over to you, Ramya.
Thank you, Shanti. That was, I think, an awesome collection of strategies we could use in cultivating a team of technology leaders. Now let's see the other areas, right, the barriers, the challenges we face in doing that. So we did interview a lot of technology leaders, that team members, as to ask them, like, what are the common pitfalls you face? And the first thing that jumped out was lack of interest. People tend to be satisfied with what they are doing, which is great, but they don't want to take the step forward in terms of leadership. So what we could do, we could sit with them, focus on their strengths, and at least encourage them, motivate them to become a thought leaders in those areas. The second thing that jumped out was lack of confidence. In fact, we have like a lot of well-documented case studies for it. So what we could do is, like, sometimes it happens that even if they are interested, they'll be like, maybe I'm not the right fit for it. So we should improve their confidence, right? So we should give them opportunities, and not only that, provide them the training, support, and a feedback cycle so that they can sustain that momentum. So on the other hand, we have positional power. Positional power is great, can achieve many things. However, that itself can turn out disastrous if they are being misused. We have gone through this, right? So what do we need to do? We need to create a respectful and an inclusive culture with the right amounts of checks and balances so that people don't use or overuse their positional power. Making decisions independently. This is something like offshoot of what I told you earlier. Like people with positional power, they don't even consult their teams. They just go ahead and make their decisions. I know teams where people don't know as to what their end product is going to be. Right? So what we need to do, we have to create retrospective meetings, solicit active team feedback, and then create an environment so that like everybody is aligned on their vision as well as their end goal. And talking about feedbacks, we love when it is nice, but when it is critical, we tend to get defensive about it. It's important that we focus on how not to repeat the mistakes and focus on your end results. And last but not the least, sometimes leaders are insecure that they don't want to hire anybody above their skill level. Again, remember, you're not hiring a competitor. You're hiring a contributor for your team. So the stronger your team is, both you and your team is going to shine. So we did see some of the individual perspectives where you can focus, motivate. But what about factors outside your scope? maybe you are having a distributed system, remote team members across time zones. Or you might have a diverse set of people, right? With different skills, different background, or different technology altogether, but they are all like subgroups of the same team. Or it could be like you have too many processes. So you think, I have to install a new software. Oh, then go through process 1, 2, and 3. That's it. You give up that idea. Or you could have a stricter hierarchy in your system, in your company, that even if you're interested, you're not getting enough opportunities. So we did go through them as well. One main problem, what you can see as, it's not working. Okay. So one main problem, if you see in all this, is communication, right? So what we did go through this, and thanks to the advancement in technology that we have like Zoom, Slack, etc. to keep us updated. And one effective service, particularly like if you are like remote team members, is video conferencing. It kind of gives you that you are as though in person, in that room, in your team meetings and in your team celebrations. And the other underlying problems that we have seen here is, think about the elaborate runbook that you have to create. Let's say you are in an integration team and then everybody has a different life cycle. Then you spend time, like you have to like coordinate all their life cycles, right? And also, what about like finger pointing? Problems arise, it's my team. No, it's a problem with the other team, right? So we have agile methodologies thanks to that. Like it regulates teamwork and like kind of helps us. And also what we do is we have one of our team members represent us and participate in other cross-stream scrums. What it helped us is we are able to understand their processes, their life cycle, as well as their pain points. Again, I would recommend architect review course. What we do is like we tech leads get together and we kind of discuss the underlying architectural decisions that was taken both in the past as well as in the future. All this have helped us to create a shared mindset instead of silos or subgroups and promote us versus them mentality. Okay, we do have pitfalls in decision making strategies. What is the main one? The first one that we saw was the technology overload. As technology leaders, we are very enthusiastic about all those innovative technologies. We want them ASAP into our organization. But we have to take a step back to see whether there is really any compelling business use case for it. And also, the other things about the vendors. Sometimes we get locked into the vendors. We spend so much budget into it. But that you also have to take a step back to see whether we are getting any real value add out of it for all the costs that we are spending. And over engineering, we all love it. We want to throw in all the fantasy solutions in it. Yes, we revel in that robustness, but sometimes all it takes is a simple, straightforward solution that's going to address your business needs. And finally, that is like, anytime you have a quick fix, what do? We patch. Again, patch. Patch it. But we have to think about the maintenance costs and the impact that it's going to have in different systems. We need to be aware of all these pitfalls and make sure that we are not falling prey to them. To wrap up this session, we saw how strategies that you can use for cultivating your team of technology leaders and the pitfalls that you should not fall prey through. Ultimately, you should remember that everybody can be a leader. Leadership is not really tied to any title or a role that you play. It's an art. You develop, you experiment, and then you taste the success. And if you have failures, learn from it and go on. Leadership is definitely a continuous journey which you consciously sustain and evolve as you grow. And as you see with the experience, you can then see the big picture. Then you can streamline, you can process, and then like you can pull in the right members so that together you're going to build a team of transformative technology leaders. Thank you for attending us today. I hope this has been kind of a little eye-opener for you. If it was, we are very glad we are able to share our experience. If you are thinking like, yeah, I have gone through this, this is something that I know of it, well, then you are not alone. At least we both share the same experiences. So we did create a trail mix with all the awesome trailhead modules that kind of helped us or motivated us. And we would like all to thank all our technology leaders whom we interviewed as part of this exercise. And thank you for attending our session today.